This year, the state of Oregon is predicted to be the site of a brand new volcanic eruption per a team of scientists. Thankfully, they are not referring to one of the state's traditionally thought of 13 active volcanoes shown here, but rather a submarine volcano offshore of the state. There, approximately 290 miles or 467 kilometers west of where the Columbia River meets the Pacific Ocean, is the large underwater edifice of the Axial Seamount volcano. While this volcano might initially look intimidating, especially with a nearly 500-foot-deep caldera that is comparable in size to the infamously explosive Crater Lake volcano, it isn't all that concerning. If Axial Seamount were to soon erupt, such an eruption would almost certainly be harmless, not posing a threat to anyone. But for me, other volcanologists, and volcano enthusiasts, it will be scientifically interesting to observe, with potential implications for understanding and predicting activity at actually potentially dangerous shield volcanoes such as Kilauea, Mauna Loa, and Embley. So, when exactly do scientists think Axial Seamount will erupt? First off, the current prediction is actually based off of analysis performed all the way back in October of 2024, which analyzed the amount of total uplift the summit of the volcano has experienced. Axial Seamount in recent times has essentially always erupted when the amount of ground uplift, which, mind you, directly translates to the amount of shallow magma refilling its primary magma chamber, reaches approximately the same level as the caldera floor was directly preceding the last eruption plus or minus 20 centimeters or 8 inches. Well, since Axial last erupted in 2015, its caldera floor has risen to 98% of the height it lost as a result of that last eruption, totaling about 1.5 meters or 59 inches. With this in mind, Axial Seamount has experienced three different rates of uplift during the last 5 years, so I will be extrapolating all of these to the present level of the caldera floor. Since greatly accelerated landrise has been ongoing since April 2024 and has remained fairly constant, the first figure will represent the most likely outcome, assuming that this heightened uplift continues up until its next eruption. If that were to occur, Axial Seamount could erupt anywhere from theoretically right now to February 2026. If, however, its uplift rate returns to its fairly average stage witnessed between most of 2021 and 2023, then Axial Seamount should erupt sometime before February 2028. But, in the highly unlikely event its ground deformation returns to the negligible inflation experienced during most of 2023 and parts of early 2024, then this volcano might not even erupt until November 2033. However, more and more data is increasingly suggesting an eruption by February 2026 as the most likely, since Axial Seamount is definably in the final of its three stages of uplift before an eruption occurs. For context, its submarine basaltic lava flows during distinct eruptions generally cover several square kilometers, averages a mere 10 feet thick, and erupts a volume of between 15 million and 90 million cubic meters of material. While an eruption could theoretically occur anywhere across its vast 237-square-mile or 615-square-kilometer edifice, the next eruption is most likely to be confined to the eastern half of its large caldera. So, with a summit at a depth of 4,547 feet or 1,386 meters below sea level, how will we ever know when this submarine shield volcano finally begins erupting? Simple, a very strong earthquake storm involving thousands of earthquakes in the time span of only a few hours. The largest of these earthquakes is typically in the magnitude 4 range, so if you see a cluster of a half dozen magnitude 2, 3, and 4 earthquakes centered within 100 miles of the Axial Seamount, it is likely erupting. Now, some brief information. Axial Seamount exists due to an underlying hotspot known as the Cobb Hotspot, with magma merely utilizing a path of least resistance created by faults belonging to and associated with a divergent plate boundary between the Pacific Plate and Juan de Fuca Plate. Here is the vent trend from this hotspot. While Axial Seamount only began forming 60,000 years ago, its caldera formed 31,200 years ago when a very large flank eruption in its northern rift zone drained a large amount of magma from its underlying magma chamber, causing the seafloor to collapse downwards to fill this empty space. Axial Seamount tends to erupt about once every 10 to 15 years, with its last eruption occurring in 2015. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Doodle Darko for supporting this channel.